Good evening. It is hard to believe that the school year is over and that this is our final concert. This year has been an amazing year filled with joy, laughter, frustration, beautiful and incredible music, and bonding between us of a last lifetime. We have made memories this year we will cherish our whole lives. We are grateful for your support and love and are happy to be here tonight to share our passion in music. Our first song is called Flight Song. It was written by Kim Arneson as a gift to Dr. Anton Armstrong, the director of the St. Olaf Choir. Last year, Dr. Armstrong was the director of the Honor Arts Choir that two of our members were selected to perform in. They were able to sing the song under the direction of Dr. Armstrong and requested that we could learn it here too. This piece talks about the effect of music and how it affects our lives, how it affects who we are, how music speaks through us, and how we use music to express what is in our hearts in times of pain and joy. We as a choir have felt the power of words in the song. We are grateful for the power and influence music has in our lives. We hope you enjoy our performance of Flight Song.
Oh, The next piece we will be performing is called Duolimon. It is an Irish folk love song with many verses, as most folk songs do. Folk songs are a way of telling stories of life, emotions, experiences, seasons, and so on. In this case, the story told in this song is about seaweed, which is what the word Duolimon means. The loose translation of this song is of a young girl who is looking for a man with specific qualities. The seaweed, in this case, is a metaphor for the kind of man that she is looking to date and eventually marry, but she is looking for the finest quality of seaweed to marry. So she seeks after the Irish seaweed because it is the best and she will only accept the best. Traditional Irish folk music usually includes a variety of instruments. Tonight, we will have our pianist, Amy Richwine, and our fiddle player from Pendleton, Dan Amer, accompany us. Please enjoy our rousing, lighthearted performance of Duolimon.
Thank you. much because we're full and tired. We have like nothing, but we do have something, and I want to make sure that we show you how much we appreciate and value your time and your talent so much, you guys.
For our next song, we would like to share with you a song from the culture of India. You might have heard it in our last concert, and we recently performed it in the Powerhouse Theater with the Walla Walla Choral Society. It was such an incredible night, and after we sang, one of the members of the choir, who is from India, told us that we did the song perfectly, and this country would be proud. It was requested by some members of the community that we sing one of our songs from our last concert, so we chose this one. Before we sing, here's an explanation. In Western music, we have two main tonalities, major and the minor. In the music of India, there are ragas, over 300 of them. Ragas are a musical mode in Indian classical music used in an improvised performance. Raga means color, and in each raga has its own unique sound and color that's associated with emotions, times of day, Hindu gods, and seasons. Ragas are an important part of Indian culture. Are a highly respected form of music used and performed in daily life, rituals, and even movies. This song, Dweeja Vanity, was arranged by Ethan Sperry from Portland State University. He has studied and worked with the famous Indian composer A.R. Rahman on many ragas from India. Dweeja Vanity is an important form of raga. Although it is normally improvised melody, Ethan Sperry described his arrangement the time he listened and watched a teacher and student improvise a melody together. He wrote down elements of the raga and created the work you are about to hear. We hope you enjoy a small taste of Indian culture life we present, Dweeja Vanity.
Yeah. Our next song is one that we recently heard while on a performance tour at two different universities, Portland State University and Pacific University. When we first heard the PSU choir sing this song, we were in awe, very moved and speechless. The power of this song is so profound that we could not describe what we were feeling when we first heard this song. And after we heard the Pacific University choir also sing this song, we knew that we needed to learn it too. Little did we know that Ms. Cunnington had this song sitting at her desk and had been pining away at it all year. This song is from South Africa. It is not in English, so you will probably not understand the words. However, if we do it well, you will understand it because you will feel it the way we did when we first heard it. In this piece, the woman expressed the idea that the Lord has taken the Son who lived amongst us, the Son of God that was crucified. The men expressed the idea of speaking to God, or Jehovah. Whenever you hear the words, Hololo, it represents the crying and the mourning of the loss they feel. This piece was first described to us as one that was written in a country where there's a lot of inequality and racism amongst the people. There's a lot of unrest and contention in this country. This composer wrote it as a way to bring people together and break down walls and boundaries so people could unite together through song. However you choose to interpret this song, we hope you are as moved by Indodana as we are.
Oh. song, we're going to sing Home by Drew Pearson. The reason we chose this song is because we sang it with the Walla Walla Choral Society at their last concert last week. We had such a great time singing it. This song is perfect for this concert because it talks about always knowing we're home. It talks about the fear of the unknown and that we're never alone. This song is perfect for our seniors who will be leaving home soon and facing their new unknowns. It can be really scary and intimidating at times, but we want them to know that we're always here for them and that Mount Rotter will always be a place to come home. We will miss our seniors, but are excited for them and their new adventures. We would like to invite them to come down and start the song, and we hope that you would join us in singing when you know the words.
Thank you.
Okay, so get ready. The waterworks are going to start. I wasn't expecting that. I saw them come off the risers and I was like, oh, that, we didn't talk about that. I was like, that's cool, good job. Or then to pull me out of breath. That was really sweet. Thank you for that, guys. Before I do this, we have somebody else I want to talk about. You guys don't know this yet, and this isn't the best time to tell you, but we don't know for sure, because it's an unknown. It's still an unknown. But Mrs. Richmond, she's been playing piano for us for 14 years now.
That's my 14 mom. Years.
And there's a chance that she might not get to play for us anymore because of the new school and her new schedule keeping her, because we rehearse in the morning and she might have to be teaching in the morning because she's a PE teacher. She's a PE teacher, she plays piano. And so, it's not much, but I wanted to give her a little something and just let her know how much she's loved. And even, I mean, I'm hoping you're back next year, but I know that the possibility is real, so I wanted to make sure we talked about that tonight and be honored and let you know how valued you are and how valued you are to me, how much I love your friendship and your positivity and the influence you've had on my children and on these children. And over the 14 years, it's been a joy to work with you, so appreciate it. Year. It's like the most bittersweet, it's most joyful because we've come so far and we get to show all of the stuff that we've done and how much we've grown in. And yet we have to say goodbye. And I hate that part so much. I hate it. Because they're my kids. And it's not very often you get put in a position to see them when they're young and bring them up. So I kind of feel like their mom, second mom in a way sometimes. And some of them I've had since like kindergarten or first grade, and others it just felt like they were in first grade the whole time, but I wanted to honor each of them with, it's a tradition I do every year, but this year I tweaked it a little bit because there's only four, so I decided I had to go above and beyond, do something a little special. And so they didn't know it at the time, but I took their pictures individually in their choir uniform, and I did it really special. What they thought I was just playing with my camera and playing filters, but I actually had a reason for it. And you'll see the pictures in the back of your program. But they have their own picture at the bottom, and at the top is a picture of the whole choir. And here in the corner is the poem that I recite before we come on stage each time. And it goes as follows. For the common things we do and say, God gave a speech in a common way. For the common things we think and feel, God gave us a poet with words to reveal. But for the heights and depths that know no reach, God gave us music for the soul's own speech. And I can't even tell you how many times in my life that has rung true to me, that music has spoken for me. It has delivered me out of times of extreme difficulty, how music has carried me, and I'm so incredibly grateful for it. I'm so incredibly grateful to share it with these people. I'm so incredibly grateful for them this year. And before I bring the seniors down, I want you to know that these students right here have changed me this year. They have changed me. And you can always change, you can always grow, you can, and they've helped me grow this year. We had some struggles, and we've been an incredible year musically, you've just heard what we've done. But we've had some struggles, and a real trial came our way that we weren't expecting, and something that I decided I was not going to let it affect me, I was not going to let it define us, and they didn't let it define us, and we rose, and we did some amazing things, and I won't go into great detail, because I think you probably know most of the story about the OSAA state debacle, and what, I don't know, I'll never have an answer, but I will tell you this. Because of that experience, I am stronger. Because of that experience, I know that there is so much more than one performance. There is so much more than one job or one thing that you were trying to get. There's so much more out there, and these students know that too, and hopefully they, like me, are stronger for it, and when that next time comes around, when the thing doesn't happen the way they wanted it to, they will press forward, and they will rise, and they will be awesome, just like we have been. And as a team, I feel so much more bonded to these students than I have, I think, my entire career. This has been an incredible year, and I'm incredibly grateful for each of you. And I want to look each of you in the eye, but there's 41 of you, and that'll take forever. And I want you to know that I love you. I love you, and I care about you, and I think about you, and you are dear to me. Thank you for what you do for me every day. Thank you. And so, let's bring down the seniors. I want to start with Grace Miller. Musically, in drama, theater, as a person, she is so strong, she is so committed, and she wanted so badly, she did everything she could to be in Crimson and Black, and she went above and beyond, and I'm so grateful that she did that, because she showed me what true determination really means, and I know that that is going to carry you everywhere in your life. If there is something Grace Miller wants, Grace Miller is going to get it, and I am so sure of that, and I'm really grateful, and I'm so excited to see where your road is going to take you, my dear. Next, we have Guillermo Castillo. Guillermo, this is a guy who has the best sense of humor that doesn't try. He is the funniest person on the planet and doesn't even make an effort to be that way. You guys know what I'm talking about. Like, it's insane the things that he says, and we just fall on the floor laughing. And he does that in drama and theater, and that's one of those things that you have a gift. You have a gift to make people happy. You have a gift to make people enjoy life and be around you. And people love to be around you, and that is something you should cherish forever in your own. And I am grateful for you. And I'm grateful for you being here, okay? Okay, I'm gonna cry real hard with either one, so. Okay, here we go. Let's bring down Adrian Martinez.
Thank you.
know, because he's not prepared with anything, but I was hoping maybe he'd throw something out there. Anyways, okay, Adrian, you are going to go really far in life. He has a scholarship for soccer, and he is determined to get out there and play ball and just blaze his own trails, and I know you're going to do just that. And last but certainly not least, Kaya Clark, come on down.
Just give it a try, and I'm glad I got pressured into it.
As we send our seniors off.